Our client, Lee Johnson, got $40 million in compensatory damages. That means the jury felt that his pain and suffering, his medical costs, and all of the costs of getting that disease, his shortened life, were worth $40 million.
I'm glad to be here to help with this situation after I learned about Roundup and glyphosate and everything. I'm glad to be here to be able to help with a cause that's way bigger than me.
And the jury gave $250 million in punitive damages because they believe that Monsanto had behaved in a reprehensible way, because we were able to show them that for 40 years, Monsanto knew that Roundup was carcinogenic, and it made great efforts to hide that from regulators and from the American public.
Het was een erg belangrijke uitspraak vorige maand. Voor het eerst werd bewezen geacht dat een man lymfeklierkanker had gekregen door onkruidverdelger Roundup. En dat fabrikant Monsanto al jarenlang wist dat het product schadelijk was.
If Monsanto had warned the public, our client, we wouldn't have had a case. Because our client could go ahead and use it anyway.
Just put it on the box.
But if there was a warning, he wouldn't have had a case.
Monsanto ontkende altijd staalhard dat het product onveilig was. Je kon het zelfs drinken, zeiden de verdedigers.
You can drink a whole quart of it and it won't hurt you.
You want to drink some? We have some here.
I'd be happy to, actually. But you, not really, but...
Not really?
I know it wouldn't hurt me.
If you say so, I have some glyphosate.
No, I'm not stupid.
It was because Monsanto chose to tell the world that this product is as safe as table salt. You can drink it. Now, all of these things that Monsanto was telling people for years, it made people use the product in ways that they weren't being careful. They weren't wearing protective clothing. They were, you know, spraying it on their animals and where their children play because they were told it's safe.
De advocaten konden tijdens de rechtszaak met interne memo's aantonen dat Monsanto weet had van schadelijke effecten. Onder andere dat het product veel gemakkelijker via de huid opgenomen werd dan eerder gedacht.
Monsanto had a legal obligation to turn that study over to the Federal Environmental Protection Agency, but their memos inside Monsanto show that they made a decision we're going to hide this from the EPA.
Ondertussen doken ook memo's op waaruit blijkt dat het bedrijf overal mollen had, ook binnen het Amerikaanse Milieuagentschap.
Memos between Monsanto and a mole that they had in EPA. So the head of the EPA pesticide division was actually under Monsanto's control. And he was in there doing killing studies and doing mischief in order to protect the product.
Het is zo dat Monsanto jarenlang de waarheid kon verbergen. Tot er een onafhankelijk onderzoek kwam van het Internationaal Agentschap voor Kankeronderzoek. Een instelling van de VN waar Monsanto geen greep op had. Al probeerden ze ook daar het discours te beheersen.
One of the things is that Monsanto engaged in a PR campaign orchestrated to create outcry against IARC and discredit IARC and made up stories about the IARC scientists.
Maar de bevindingen van het agentschap werden toch voldoende ernstig bevonden door een Amerikaanse rechter. En het was die studie die tot de rechtszaak leidde en nu dus een belangrijk precedent kan zijn. Want er liggen nog veel andere zaken te wachten.
Michael and I alone have 800 cases. And the attorneys who are in our group are all friends. Have 8,000 cases. So this is going to be a very painful process for Monsanto and now for Bayer.
Chemireus Bayer heeft onlangs Monsanto overgenomen. Ze lieten al weten dat de naam zal verdwijnen. Maar de nalatenschap van Monsanto, daar zijn ze nog niet vanaf.
When Bayer purchased Monsanto, Monsanto told them we've put aside $270 million to handle all the liabilities from Roundup. And in the first case, they got a $289 million reward. So, either Bayer didn't do a proper due diligence, or Monsanto pulled the wool over their eyes, but
probably both.
Probably both.